Oh no, what have I done? This is not the usual Victoria 2 starting screen. Just give me 1 second, I need to turn this music off because it's blasting my ears. Ah, much better. Now, where was I? Ah yes. Hello there, my fellow mountaineers. It's me, Mountain General, back in Victoria 2. Well, because I'm still waiting for Wiki 3 to come out. But before that unicorn of a game comes out, it's time to go back to the good old days of Victoria 2 without any DLCs. And if you know anything about Victoria 2, it's that you can't play Victoria 2 without DLCs. It's a sin punishable by death. But hey, it's April's Fool's Day, and I'm the biggest Slovak fool, so why not inflict some cock and ball torture on me? And hey, if this video gets 5,000 likes, I will crush the British Empire with Robert E. Lee in charge, also with no DLCs. And also subscribe, because we are aiming for Banat at 50k. Now let's go back to game, back to the world of cursed Victoria 2. And yeah, you see why it is cursed, because of yellow Prussia. There is just so much wrong with it, I don't have to explain it. It would be better if they just swapped the colors of Prussia and Belgium. But no, they have unleashed this abomination upon us. And why the hell Switzerland isn't red? And yeah, we can't just move around the map, we need to just go to the corners of our screen to move around, so that will be fun. The worst thing about this world is that I'm not using HPM. This is vanilla, with no DLCs, if you didn't get the memo yet. And yeah, I think today there is only one country that I have to play, and that is the urine Prussia. But now, before we just jump into Prussia, I am aware that some internet provider played that nation before, not to being called by some Alzhababo HD for copying his stuff. But I never in my life played Victoria 2 without any DLCs. So I just want to make this video as a big joke. And yellow Prussia is the perfect nation for it. And yeah, I have to say that I was really scared to do this. I heard many legends about the vanilla Victoria 2, and I feel really odd right now. And we also lack a lot of map modes. Yeah, we got the diplomatic screen, right, but I can't find the spheres. But the spheres are still a thing, so we will have to still watch out for our spherelings, just more manually. I assume that most of the things that are automated are not here. And if you try to right click the nation to open up the diplomacy fast, no. Everything has to be done manually. And yeah, there is no justifying the war goal. I think you will just pick it and it will automatically give you infamy. But now we want the alliance with the British. Oh, and we can't see even the probability in numbers. Only it is very likely, but I like it more when you have the numbers. I just really love how the taxation never changed. Bruh, I don't know what is happening, but the cavalry doesn't have any horses in it. Very nice. Another thing that I don't really like is that we can't set a point where the troops will rally when they are spawned. So yeah, that's pretty annoying. But you know, at the end of the day, that doesn't matter, because we are Prussia and we will kick some ass. Now our goal as peace Prussia is to get rid of that yellow color. And what's the better way to do that than forming North German Confederation? Yeah, we need to beat up some Frenchies with our friends. Now the funny thing is that Russians never joined. This is where the fun begins. You know, we are living in very confusing times. Half of the time I don't know what is happening in combat, but it appears that we are winning. Now hopefully I am right, but I can't see the enemy troops. We don't have the see the battle screen. Yeah, that might be a problem. But the great thing is that Königsberg is safe from the Russians, so yeah, we can turn up to French border. And yeah, I can't even distinguish my soldiers from enemies, so that's a lot of fun here. I feel like I got this. I'm a professional Victoria 2 enjoyer. Nothing is too hard for me. Sometimes the battles are confusing, but we will prevail victorious for our unified Germany. Oh my, how many many French people do I have to kill until they capitulate to me? Who went to Paris? The Yellow Prussians. Now feast your eyes on Yellow Paris. Now you know what? I have nicely destroyed the whole army of France. I wanted to take Tunisia as well, but what can we do? Very nice. Now you can't even know that it's me here. Well, what can I say? Welcome to the Prussian colony. Yeah, the yellow menace is growing every day. And also now we can rename the Elsass-Lothringen. Oh yes, let's anger some French people, as always. Now friendship with Denmark ended. Now I'm going to liberate Schleswig-Holstein. Ah yes, our demands were met. Very cool, Denmark, thank you very much. Peace, Prussia. Now, after spearing all the countries in the northern German sphere, we need to say goodbye to Yellow Prussia and say hello to the Northern German Confederation. Glory to our new country. Ah, shit. This just started. And I feel like it will be with us the whole game. Yeah, it's so much fun just clicking it and not having it automatic. Fuck. You know, I know that this game just hates me. And you know what, I don't really care. Now, as we want to become a great power, a great new colonial power, we need to expand to Egypt. Yeah, I will now take the lands of Suez, so I can in the future build a huge canal there. So one day one idiot can get stuck there. Oh, and as I was just conquering stuff, France declared war on me. With big old coalition of people that want Alsace-Lorraine back. Huh. Now I got to say that this was the best NSIG I ever had in my life. I was able to reduce the French army from 180 to 44. And yeah, I will get my hegemony over the southern German states. Now we can proclaim free hurrahs for Germany, but Austria and Bavaria are now in my sphere, but I think when I declare Germany, yeah, they won't be part of it because they are great powers. Hold on, let me fix that. Now that we have just burned down the whole Bavaria, we can just now nicely form the good old regular Germany. And yes, free hurrahs indeed for the new German Empire. Well, you could also get the whole Austria, but I don't want to. I already did that, like a long time ago. I fear no man. But these pie charts, they scare me. The other thing that I noticed here is, yeah, we need to manually go to our factories to reopen them. We can't do that like all factories open now. It's just painful. But one thing I really love, like you can build so many ports. It's just crazy because you don't have a limit on your fleet, so you can build so many dreadnoughts or battleships. Now, in what bizarre world am I living in? France is just number one, and Chile is seventh. Chile! Chile! And I'm only third. What the hell? I really need answers. The Chile has almost the same amount of factories as United States of America. What's going on? Someone please explain it in the comments. Good morning, Industrial Revolution. Why do I got the feeling that this won't end up well? Ah yes, railroads! Railroads! What the hell is this? Prussian nationalists? Oh no, they want the yellow color back. It won't happen, I promise. You know what's funny? Spain is losing to Algeria. So yeah, I think I should just create my new colonial empire here in Northern Africa. Oh no, all the nationalists are just rising up. I am killing Bavarians, Saxonians. It is very nice. Now this is a colony with Spanish dingus in it. Now I gotta say, that's pretty different American Civil War. I also think that Americans forgot to manifest their destiny. Ah yes, it is this time of the game. France just wants that Alsace-Lorraine so bad. I'm not going to give it to them that easily. You know, some people will never learn. You know, the best thing is that I can end this war anytime I want, but I won't. I will burn the entirety of the France to the ground as a good Prussian. You know what, I just wanted to burn down the whole France down, but then The Prussian nationalists rose up and I can't let them win. Yeah, now the best thing is that I will have to kill my whole population. But at least you see, the German Algeria is thick. Oh yeah, and Hamburg just became independent. But not for long. Only one thing about Victoria 2 never changed. The rebels!
Motherfucker, bring it on!
Now would you look at that, the bitches just backed off. But now we need to deal with the Dutch people. Yes, we have discovered the source of the Nile. Prestige through the roof. Another interesting thing is that colonization is done through your through national focus, which is very interesting in my opinion. You know what, fuck you Netherlands, I'm taking Dutch East Indies for myself. Now welcome to German East Indies. Nice, I'm sure this will come in handy. I don't understand one thing. How is Switzerland in sphere of Austria and France at the same time? How? I need so many answers. Another day, another French liberation of Alsace-Lorraine. I think France lost ability to use critical thinking a long time ago. I think France forgot to put their armies where it matters. I will burn France so much down, they will become an uncivilized nation after this war. Now, would you look at that? That is one unusual alliance. Yo yo yo, rate my encirclement. Very juicy one. Now that I have nicely burned down the whole France, it's time to butcher them with my peace deal. Oh yeah, this is Germany. And also I took Cuba from the Spanish, so that's a fun place to be in. My nation, currently on fire. So yeah, I don't see a point with continuing my suffering. You know what, I was able to colonize a nice bit of Africa, win some wars against France, take the Dutch East Indies and make it into Deutsch Indies. And yeah, happy April's Fool's Day. Tell me in the comments, what do you think about more Victoria 2 on the channel? And like the video if you enjoyed my suffering with Yellow Prussia. And as always, big thanks goes to my channel members. Their names are in the description and on the screen right now. And a special thanks goes to Lazuli, Mongolicios and Potato Boy for being the highest channel members. See you soon!